When we reach life's greatest crossroads, the choice of the decision we make must be done with much faith and love. My dear friends, Ian and Rachel have journeyed this crossroads already with a lot of faith and a deeply nurtured friendship and love. Let us then offer our thanks to God for having led them together in this love. As we celebrate this special day, presided by Reverend Father Virgilio H. Delphine, DCM, let us join Ian and Rysel in prayer, because Christ once said that when two or three are gathered in my name, I shall be there in their midst. Let us therefore acknowledge that there is someone greater than any of us present, the Holy Spirit, who through his presence, this promise is made and a covenant is sealed. Let this day be memorable for all of us, for the Lord have given us the blessing in witnessing this.
Sir, I'm a bit nervous about being here today. Still not yet sure of what I'm going to say. So bear with me, please, if I take up too much of your time.
Beloved, be subordinate to one another out of reverence for Christ. Wives should be subordinates to their husband as to the Lord. For the husband is the head of his wife, just as Christ is the head of the church, he himself the Savior of the body. As the church is subordinate to Christ, so wives should be subordinate to their husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ loved the church and handed himself over her. Husbands should love their wives as their own bodies. He who loves his wife loves himself. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh.
Here in this box is a ring for your oldest. She's my everything, and I know that it would be such relief if I knew that we were on the same side. Very soon I'm hoping that I guess somehow I always knew this day would soon be here. Still I want to look at you, what became of all the years, and no words could ever quite express the way I feel inside. Oh, I can't believe my eyes today. My daughter is a bride. Can marry a daughter, make her my wife. Want her to be the only girl that I love for the rest of my life. Give her the best of me till the day that I die. Gonna marry your princess, make her my queen. She'll be the most beautiful bride that I ever seen. Can't wait to smile, she walks down the aisle. I'm a father the day that I marry a daughter.
Oh, I can't believe my eyes today. My daughter. Oh, I can't believe my eyes. My daughter. Oh, my angel and my pride. My daughter.
Thank you. Raizel, did you come here freely and without reservations to bind yourself in marriage to Ian, forever to love and serve him as your husband?
Yes, Father.
Ian, did you come here freely and without reservations to bind yourself in marriage to Raizel, forever to love and serve her as your wife?
Yes, Father.
Are you both ready to raise as good Christians the children whom God will give you?
Yes, Father.
Ian and Raizel, since both of you freely bind yourselves to the sacrament of holy matrimony, join your right hands, and answer my questions. Ian, do you take Raizel, whom you have, you now hold by hand, to be your wife?
I do.
Raizel, do you take Ian, whom you now hold by hand, to be your husband? Do you mutually promise in the presence of this community that you will at all times and in all circumstances conduct yourselves toward one another as husband and wife?
We do.
Ian, years back, I sent you a message saying our meeting was a part of God's intricate plan, and I want you to know that it still stands true up to this very moment. I have always been a believer that when you pray, you have to be very specific, even to the tiniest details. I wasn't sure then what to pray. I guess because I didn't know what I want, or maybe I wasn't praying much harder. But then, I realized that I should be thanking God for an unanswered prayer. Because by not answering my prayer, He gave me simply the best. He gave me you. And so I asked myself, you are my gift from God. But what do you do with gift? You treasure them. And so I vow to treasure you, to love you.
My Raizel, I am the happiest man on earth right now because I make you happy. Ga, my vow is very simple and from the heart. As your husband, my primary responsibility from the very start is to bring you to heaven. And I will do that. I love you, and I will love you, protect and provide you comfort in good times and in bad. I will be forever your best friend. I got your back. I will be there for you no matter what. From this day onwards, I am not only your husband, but a part of me. In front of these people and God, you have me all the days of my life, and I will die for you. I love you forever. If not for you, I would not be here. I thank God for giving me a life with you.
Forever, Daddy. Yes, inside the box. Belongs to you. Take care of it. I've been asking to have this again.
Time I lost and give it back to you, but you just smile and take my hand. You've been there, you understand. It's all part of a grander plan that is coming true. Every long lost dream led me to where you
are. This isn't about quitting. This is about my commitment to you. So always remember that I have promises to make and vows to keep. I concede. We have come quite a long way, and the road we've traveled ain't easy. But if I have to take a detour, I would still choose the path that would lead me back straight to you. journal journey can never be more fun, ever be more exciting, and completely wonderful than a journey with you, walking on the road with you. I am very sorry, God. I wasn't born to become a runner. I couldn't run a mile. I will walk forever with you. Thank you for being my rock. You are and always will be my God-given solace. I love you forever.
Let me stray to you.